Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Swadhin Mahapatra, and today we'll discuss some things regarding NMC and MCA. What the changes after coming to existence of NMC? What changes have been made? Sorry, I forgot to refer. NMC is the National Medical Commission, which came into existence after resolving of MCA, that is Medical Council of India. And Medical Council of India was dissolved because after the arrest of MCA's president Ketan Desai by CBI in 2010. After that, the government decided to pass a bill as the NMC bill, the National Medical Commission. And so after coming to existence, finally NMC have made some big changes. One of the most prominent big change came recently, before few days, in which they have removed the list of universities and institutions which used to be in the website of Medical Council of India, that such are the institutes in which you can go to study medicine or do your MBBS in other countries. So what the NMC did recently, they removed that list from the website, and they have put some criteria in which students can go out for studies. So see, when something is done, there is a good and bad aspect of the decision. So when there was a list of university in which only in those institutes or those universities in different countries students can go and study. So when a student decide that okay, I want to go study abroad, so what happened, they start searching the websites, okay, which are the institutes I can go to study. But now after the decision of NMC, the list of the universities has been removed completely, and they have decided you can study in any university, you can study in any university in any country. In regards, the university must be recognized in the country, in their own home country itself. So in this there are some good aspects, some bad aspects. So first let's discuss one by one. Good thing is, sometimes you know, you have to travel to countries where the university fee is more, living expense is more. And now the students are free to travel to the countries or study in universities where the university fee is less. University fee is less and they can afford it. There are so many there are so many universities all over the world which are not recognized by MCA due to they could not reach out to MCA, or maybe they could not provide the infrastructure needed by the government of India at that time, or MCA at that time, because of which it was not recognized. But now, and there was a very lengthy paperwork to do before the institute or the university has to be recognized by the Medical Council of India, which is now the National Medical Commission. So now, as it's been removed, now all the universities are open to take students from India. They can study. Yeah, there are certain rules and regulations for the students to go abroad, that you can go directly to the website of NCA, that is nmc.org.in. From there, you can go to the information desk, and in the information desk, there is one label as for students to study abroad. You can go and complete the rules and regulations which is required before you travel to any country for the MBBS studies. So now, one more good thing which NMC did by removing the list. Now students don't have to worry about anything. They can choose any university in any country to go and study there. But you know, with the good, there are some bad aspects also. So first, I'll say there will be a raise for the students, and in other countries, you know, some universities in which the fee structure is less, the fees are less, they don't have that infrastructure which can afford a large number of students, or they don't have the new equipments or modern infrastructure which is necessary for the students to go for MBBS. So from my view, I will request the students that don't simply choose a university because the fees are less or the fee is less there, or you can afford it. So you have to go through all the his history, how the students are studying, talk to the students over there, how is the university, how they are studying, because and mostly you will not find any Indian students in such universities, because till now it was not recognized by the Medical Council of India, National Medical Council. But now as National Medical Council have removed the list, now there will be lots of students. There are lots of students where you can study. So now what happens? Secondly, the unavailability of teaching staff. You see, when there were not much English speaking students in the university, but now India is one of the biggest market from where the students go to different countries to study MBBS. I think almost every year more than 30,000-40,000 students go abroad to study only medicine. So now there are small countries, I will not mention the names, there are countries in which the fees are less, and there was no English speaking courses there, English speaking teachers there to teach the students, because the main mode of teaching will be the English for all foreign students in any country. So now what will happen? Yeah, they will show you, yeah, we have English speaking teachers, but no, because they are not experienced. They are not experienced to teach you. So that will be one more negative point by this. Now, see, there are some countries where they welcome students very, very nicely, because students have been in that city or in that country from long time. For example, in Ukraine and Kyiv, Kharkiv, some cities in Russia, St. Petersburg, Crimea, they welcome the students because it's been long time where the students have been studying, and they are very regular by seeing the foreigners or foreign students living a long time there, and they're like, they see them every day. When you go to a new place and there is a lot of foreigners, lot of students, sometimes the local people don't welcome it very nicely. Okay, so always choose a university in which already students are studying, or the city in which students are there, which is friendly. So you have to check all this. Even if the NMC have removed the list, it's not that, yeah, you close your eyes and you can go to any university. You have to check all the aspects. Now, one more point I'll say. The teaching staff, then the staff, and now when someone goes to a new country or new institute, new medical university, if you don't have a senior, yeah, there is always first time for everyone, but if you don't have senior, you're going to face problems in admission process, in helping you in studies, and in each and everything. So always choose a city or country where already students are studying, the institute where the already Indian students are studying. Go talk to the students, try to contact them anyhow. There are raise the media, world of social media, you can contact them through any chance, and by any you can contact them. So contact them and try to get all the details of the history of the university. Yeah, some new universities have opened up in recent years, and yeah, the infrastructure is very good in some of the universities I have myself visited, and the infrastructure is very good, and already around more than 100-150 students are studying there. Okay, so try such universities where already students are studying, because there should not be a hole for the countries or universities where no one already studying. For reason I told you already: one, you may not be welcomed by the locals; second, you may not, the teaching staff may not be well prepared for you, because as though India is a very big market for students who go abroad. So when the NMC have removed, now the universities know, yeah, they are going to be Indian students who are coming. So let's prepare for them. But they don't have enough time, or you can't prepare a teaching staff to teach you in English completely in a month or in a year. You need experience for that, which they don't have. So my suggestion to all the students, going to go abroad for studies, check the history, talk to the students, talk to the faculty of the university, and talk to any known person whom you know around the university or in the same country. Find out everything, then only take admissions. And yeah, you can send me personal messages, or you can send message to my inbox if you need any help regarding any university in Ukraine or Russia for admissions. Thank you. Bye. Yeah, in the next section we'll discuss about the exam pattern. This is the second big change which NMC have done, the exam pattern. Before, it used to be the FMJ exam, we can say the M3 exam, which the students have to go and pass after studying from abroad. But now, as per the NMC, the exam pattern have been changed, and it's now compulsory for everyone. Either you study in India or you study abroad, it's compulsory for everyone to give the exam. So all those details we'll discuss in the next session. Thank you.